Do you listen to Christmas music all year round?
Yeah.
Oh, Jason, I love you. That's great news.
Jason Momoa is here, everyone. How exciting. Aqua Man in the country. We've arranged a special thing for you. We've got this special sky water that we've done around London today, just so you feel at home, so you're comfortable with the water.
Thank you.
That's very much our climate. Apologies for that. How are you?
I'm awesome.
Good, good. Congratulations on Aquaman.
Thank you.
Did
they let you watch it?
Yeah.
Did you watch it?
I did watch it, yeah. It was very wet, wasn't it? It's brilliant. But you must have been like moist for months.
In denim, nevertheless. Moist denim.
Mind you,
you're the guys. It was a lot of hard work, but I mean, I'm pretty excited to see the show.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him. I'm going to wait for my baby, so they were with me when I shot it. So they're 10 and 11.
Yeah.
I leave here, go to New York, and then LA premiere, and they'll hold their hands, and we're going to watch it together.
Have you not seen it?
Not yet, no.
So tempted to tell you what happens at the end, but I'm not going to.
I know what happens.
I'm not. How do you know if you've not seen it?
I read it.
Oh, yeah, no, hang on. It's a huge, I mean, it's an epic movie, right? It's massive. Everything about it is massive. The characters are massive. The stars in it are massive. You're massive.
Thank you. We can go
there, can't we? How tall are you?
6'4".
6'4", okay, all right. How is it to film an epic film? What's that like? Does it take ages to film those tiny moments, or is it just like any other movie?
No, that was a long time. We did 7 months, but we had like a solid month of just training before we started. So, and then it's, you know, 2 hours to put those tattoos on every morning.
That's
so
insane.
Before people roll up, you put the tattoos on, and then you go to set and work all day, and it takes about an hour to get them off.
No way. So you can't just sleep on your tats?
No.
Oh man.
Take them off every day.
Oh man, that's so you get there 2 hours before everyone else.
Yeah.
So what time would you start in the morning, then?
I get up probably about 5, get in the car at 5:30, and then crew calls normally at 8.
It's a lot like doing Magic Weekend breakfast, to be honest. It's a similar thing to a breakfast radio show. I have to take my tattoos off at the end of every show. I also saw, because obviously I'm a huge fan of Game of Thrones, I saw the other day the video of your audition for Game of Thrones.
Oh yeah.
You did the HAKA!
Yeah.
It's the coolest audition I've ever seen.
I was unsure if I was going to do it. I asked my buddy, and he's like, yeah, you got to do it. But it was weird because it was just two little nice ladies recording. And I'm like, oh, do you mind if I try something first before we do the audition? And they're like, oh, please, be delighted. And then I just start getting into it, which is rather scary. And people are popping their heads in, making sure everything's all right.
Yeah, exactly.
And you
sang them a war song, Jason.
Yeah.
That's what you did. And that's how, I mean, was that your first big part? Was that your breakthrough part?
For Game of Thrones, yeah.
Yeah. That's how you started your career with a HAKA.
Yeah.
That's really cool, man.
Thank you.
Are you a fan of rugby then as well? You're a fan of rugby?
Huge fan of rugby.
Are you?
I used to have dreadlocks, and the moment that the All Blacks lost and woke up, I went home, put my baby in my arms, and I cut all my dreads out and had them for like 6 years.
Seriously?
I'm a massive All Blacks fan.
Also, Magic is going 100% Christmas now. We are playing nothing but Christmas music. You're a fan of Christmas tunes?
I love Christmas tunes.
Yeah? What's your favorite Christmas album, Jason?
Surprisingly, my favorite Christmas CD is Barbara Streisand's Christmas Carol, from the 70s.
Okay.
It's beautiful. She does like Ave Maria, and it's just gorgeous. You should get it.
Okay. Well, we can probably play one now on Magic. This is Magic Weekend Breakfast. We're playing Christmas music.
Yeah.
Let's play a bit of
Barbara Streisand. Yeah.
Here we go. I've been on the Googles to have a look at you, see what's going on there. And I've seen what the most popular questions about you are, right? Are you prepared to answer a couple?
Oh, boy.
Okay, it's fine, don't worry. So first of all, is Jason Momoa related to The Rock?
No.
Okay, it's a simple answer. Is Jason Momoa vegan? That is the second biggest question that's asked about you.
Hell no.
Okay, he needs his meat.
He's a meat eater.
Red meat.
I like medium rare.
Does Jason Momoa speak Spanish? I don't know why the people of Google are asking this question.
I mean, I couldn't hold a conversation. I know about Cerveza and El Baño, and that's about it.
So you do speak a bit Spanish?
I can order a beer and find out where the bathroom is.
Do you want to know my only Spanish phrase? It's very useful. This is the only thing I remember from GCSE Spanish. Hay un banco por aquí? Is there a bank nearby? You never know, Jason. You never know. You might need it.
¿Dónde está Petalones?
There you go, exactly. I had no
where
idea what you just
said.
Where
are my pants?
Is that what it is?
Where are my pants?
Also, this is a great one. Where does Jason Momoa buy his clothes?
I'm pretty simple. My buddies make these pants, which I've worn in pretty much every movie. And his name is Schaefer's Garment Hotel on Sunset in Los Angeles.
Thick denim, right?
Do
you mind if I touch your pants? Oh, they sort of move and then hold their shape. Oh, those are really good.
You can go down on your motorcycle, you'll be fine.
Do they ever blow at the crotch? I bet they don't blow at the crotch, do they?
No. This and cockroaches will last at the end of the earth.
That's all that's going to be left at the end.
Jason's jeans.
That would be a unique selling point, to be honest. I've got a prize for you. Okay. Right, a little prize for you, Aquaman. It's this. It's one of the most sought-after bits of recycled bamboo in the world. All right, so along with your jeans, this bamboo will last until the end of time. It's the Magic Weekend Breakfast Travel Cup. Okay?
It's awesome. I'm pretty excited.
Thanks, man. So what we're going to do, Jason, because you are Aquaman, we're going to play a game of fake or lake, right? Because you're Aquaman, you should know about bodies of water, right? I'm going to read out a list of bodies of water, reservoirs and lakes, and you have to tell me if they are fake or if they are an actual lake. You ready for this?
Ready.
Okay, right, here we go. Lake Pretty Boy. Is that fake or lake?
Fake.
You think that's fake? It's a lake, Jason. It's a lake. Come on, Aquaman. I expected more. Apparently, it provides Baltimore with most of its water.
Really?
Yeah, there you go. See? Fact fans, put that in. Christmas Lake.
Fake.
It's massive fake. You're right, I made that up. Chewing Gum Lake.
Real.
You think you're going to go for lake?
I'm going to go for lake.
It is a lake. Congratulations. It is in, yeah. Emigrant Wilderness in California. There you go. You're doing very well. Lake Land.
Fake.
Yeah, it's a shop. Just sells things like this mug. Lakeland. And then finally, this is my favourite one. Lake Titicaca.
Real.
It's real! Yes, it's on the border of Bolivia and Peru. It is a lake. Jason Momoa, Aquaman. Congratulations.
Yes!
You got the cup. Congratulations, Jason Momoa. Brilliant scenes. You've won the mug that I was going to give you anyway.
I've never won anything ever. Thank you.
Really? I'm so excited about this. Someone get that man a flat white to put in there. Jason, congratulations on Aquaman. I'm not going to tell you what happens in the film, but it is really good. Jason Momoa, hooray! Thank you so much. That was lovely.